We'll start for our subject, that is hydrology and water resources engineering, that is HWRE. Okay, I welcome all of you. Now today we are going to start for the unit number 1. That is a hydrology. In whatever the one, so unit number 1 is a hydrology. Then its a weightage of the marks for university examination is about 4 plus 3 7 7 plus 1, that is 8, means 7 to 6 to 9 marks weightage is there for the university examination point of view. Then its a contents are first one is introduction to hydrology, so definition, history and importance of hydrology, the hydrological cycle, weather and its precipitation potential, then its forms and types of precipitation. I would like to mute all. Okay. Then different methods of measurement, factors affecting precipitation at location, correcting precipitation data, estimation of the missing data, then estimation of extreme values, rain gauge network, determination of average precipitation over the catchments, analysis of precipitation data, mass rainfall curves, intensity duration curves, concept of depth area duration analysis, frequency analysis, it is there under the precipitation. The next part is evaporation and evapotranspiration. It includes factors affecting evaporation, measurement and control of evaporation upon the reservoirs. Then regarding evapotranspiration, it's a definition and it's a measurement. And then the infiltration, which includes the part as process of infiltration, factors affecting infiltration, infiltration indices, effect of infiltration on runoff and groundwater recharge. Okay, so this is about the syllabus of the unit. It is a hydrology unit number 1 that we had seen yesterday. Now we'll start for our actual syllabus for the unit number 1. So firstly, we will see that what does it mean about the hydrology. Firstly, though we had some preliminary discussion in the yesterday's lecture about the hydrology, how its cycles occurs and all those things. Now we'll go in the detail part of that. Okay, so what is meant by hydrology and its associated. Previous lecture, previous discussions which we had over the hydrology. So looking into the details of the hydrology. So hydrology is a Greek word, which is combination of the two words. The first word, that is a hydro, which means the water, and the second word, that is a logy, it means the study. So hydrology is nothing but the combination of the water and its study. It means that the hydrology is nothing but the whole study of the water. Now you may have a question in the mind that, then if you are saying that the study of water is there, and then what does it mean about the fluid mechanics and all those things? So here hydrology means about the study of the water, or the science of the water rather, we can say, that is from its preliminary phase, that is from its formation phase, we can say. That is, how does it occurs, how does it forms, and how we are going to explore it for various purposes, or how it will be utilized for further purposes, and again how it continues its cycle, that comes under the hydrology. So in the sense, we can say that the hydrology means the science of water, which is nothing but the, or which is deals about the occurrence, circulation and distribution over the earth and below the earth. Means over the earth, it may be over the ground surface, or it may be in the atmosphere, and below the earth means whatever the groundwater we are getting, that groundwater. It means that the hydrology in the broad sense is the water science which deals with the occurrence, circulation and distribution of the water throughout the atmosphere, over the earth surface and beneath the earth surface. So this is a brief idea about the hydrology. म्हणजे थोडक्यात काय झालं, हायड्रोलॉजी म्हणजे काय, तर पाणी आपण जे म्हणतो ती पाणी ऑकरन्स म्हणजे सापडणे, म्हणजे कसं तयार होतं, त्याचं सर्क्युलेशन म्हणजे डिस्ट्रीब्युशन कसं होतं, आणि त्याचं ऑकरन्स म्हणजे त्याचं डिस्ट्रीब्युशन जे असेल ते डिस्ट्रीब्युशन तुमचं मग सर्फेसवरचं असेल अर्थच्या, किंवा अॅटमॉस्फिअर मधलं असेल, किंवा जमिनीमधलं असेल,
ह्या सर्वच्या सर्व गोष्टींचा स्टडी हा पूर्णपणे हायड्रोलॉजीमध्ये केला जातो. आता आपण बऱ्याच वेळा आपल्या मनामध्ये प्रश्न आला असेल की बाबा रे ऍटमॉस्फिअर मध्ये वॉटर कसं येणार, सो व्हॉट एव्हर द मॉइश्चर वी आर गेटिंग वी आर ऑब्झर्विंग इन द ऍटमॉस्फिअर दॅट इज नथिंग बट द वॉटर वी कॅन से. सो इन सेन्स आय वुड लाईक टू रिपीट अगेन द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हायड्रोलॉजी. इट इज अ सायन्स दॅट डील्स विद द ऑकरन्स सर्क्युलेशन अँड डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ओव्हर द अर्थ सर्फेस दॅट इज इन द ऍटमॉस्फिअर ऑर बिनिथ द अर्थ सर्फेस. दॅट इज अबाउट द हायड्रोलॉजी. देन इट इज कन्सर्न्ड विथ मीन्स नाउ विथ नाउ वी आर नोइंग वी आर गेटिंग आयडिया दॅट नाउ द हायड्रोलॉजी इज रिलेटेड टू द वॉटर ओनली. सो नाउ आफ्टर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द or after after formation of the precipitation that is after getting the water, that hydrology concerns with the water in the streams, lakes, rainfall, snowfall, etc., etc., and the water occurring the below the earth surface. It means that the whatever the water we are getting therein, is I am audible? Details. Okay, so this is about a definition of the hydrology. Now we'll see that the hydrological cycle, so how that formation of the precipitation, how the rainfall occurs, again it goes to the ocean seas, again it evaporates, again there is a formation of the clouds, then there's condensates, then there is again a rainfall or snowfall. If rainfall is there, then some amount of the water used to infiltrate in the soil. Then it joins to the springs, then it joins to the streams, rivers, again goes to the oceans, again there is a formation of vapors and clouds likewise. So this cycle continues. So we'll see that now in detail how the hydrologic cycle occurs and what are its different components. Okay, so with the sketch we'll go for describing it. So here we are finding that this is the precipitation occurring here. It has been shown here. We'll start from the basic principle. In the next here we will get that this is an sea or ocean we can consider, or the lake we can consider, from where there is a evaporation, and that evaporation is due to the sun radiations. This is a sun which has been shown over here, due to which there is a evaporation of the water from the body of the water surface, or from the water body we can say. That water body may be the sea, ocean, lake, pond, streams, rivers, canals, etc., etc. Means wherever we are finding that the water bodies, the stored water, from that stored water due to the sun radiations, it occurs the evaporation. It results in an evaporation of the top surface of the water body, and after the evaporation, that evaporated mass of the air moves in upward direction. As here occurs the evaporation due to the movement of the air, it means that due to the evaporation, that is due to the rise in a temperature we can say, whatever the water vapors will be there, those are having the less density, they moves in upward direction, and at the same time the cold air used to occupy this space. So here the arrows are showing the direction. Okay, so here that cold air will take the position, and this vaporized air will move in a further vertically upward direction. Not only that water vapors, but from the plants, trees, then greeneries, or wherever we are finding the crops, from those crops also there is a evapotranspiration. That is, they used to release some amount of the water through their leaves, and from that part, or from the whatever amount of the water droplets those used to there over the body of the trees or the body of the leaves of the plants and the trees, from that also, due to the there occurs a evaporation, or that released vapor from the trees and crops, it also joins the evaporated mass from the seas and oceans, and ultimately they move in upward direction. And once they move in upward direction, they gets condensates there. If they get condensates, and the conditions are prevailing to that again getting a cold and cold mass, then in that case there occurs a precipitation. Or if there occurs a wind, then then that condensed mass is to move further. Here we are finding that. That's those mass we used to treat as an occlusion. Means after their evaporation and evapotranspiration, whatever the moist air is to get collected or moist air is to have an some mass at a particular place in a space, they that mass we used to call as an clouds, and they those clouds gets moves further in the direction of the winds. And if the winds are not there in that case, due to the again in the further movement in upward direction, when their temperature goes below and below, or temperature goes on reducing and reducing, the whole mass gets condensed, and it results in the change in phase of the water vapors to the droplets. And then those droplets used to fall over the ground surface or over the seas and oceans or over the trees and grasses or the crops. So this evaporated mass, after moving in upward direction, condenses, it cools, and again it converts into the water droplets, and then in the form of the precipitation, it falls over the ground surface or over the oceans or the seas or where they are getting condensed. Now, the precipitation may be in the form of the rainfall, it may be in the form of snowfall, it may be the drizzle, it may be the slates, it may be the flakes, etc., etc. It means that whatever the condensed mass used to fall over the surface of earth or the water bodies, that mass we used to treat it as a precipitation. Here it has been shown that small water droplets are shown herein. We can treat them as a water droplets, or we can treat it as an ice crystals. Okay, or the snowfall we can treat. So when it again comes in contact or when appears over the surface, consider here as over the mountains or the hills or the earth surface, we can say, after falling over the earth surface, if this is a rainfall, in that case some amount of that rainfall or some amount of that precipitation moves over the surface. Okay, some amount of the rainfall moves over the ground surface, and it joins the streams, rivers, and at the last oceans or the reservoirs. Those are artificially formed for the conservation of the water, we can say. It means that out of the total precipitated mass, some amount of the mass used to flow over the surfaces, and it joins the water bodies, small water bodies. It may be the stream, river, and at the last the larger water bodies, that is oceans and seas. But out of that total precipitation, some amount of the water infiltrates in the soil, and it deep percolates in under the soil surface, and the deep percolated amount of the precipitation or the water joins the water bodies, means the groundwater table, we can say, and it results in the increase in the groundwater body or increase in the groundwater table. And after some time or after at some locations we used to find, whenever there is a occurrence of the rainfall over the mountains and the hills, we used to find some springs. आपल्याला बऱ्याच वेळा डोंगरावरती झरे पाहायला मिळतात. हे झरे म्हणजे काय असतात, तर ज्या वेळेस पडलेल्या पावसाचं काही प्रमाणामध्ये अमाऊंट ते जमिनीमध्ये मुरलेलं असतं, ते जमिनीमध्ये मुरलेलं पाणी नंतर ना आवाज कट होतोय करे इन बिटवीन. जमिनीमध्ये जे मुरलेलं पाणी असणार आहे, ते जमिनीमध्ये मुरलेलं पाणी खाली डीप पर्क्युलेट होत जातं, तसंच जमिनीमध्ये आतमध्ये जातं, भूगर्भामध्ये जातं, आणि नंतर ना ते आतमधले ज्या कॅव्हिटी असतात त्यांना आपण ऍक्विफर असं म्हणतो, त्या ऍक्विफर्सना जॉईन होतो, आणि ऍक्विफर मधलं अमाऊंट जास्त झाल्यानंतर ना ऍक्विफरला कुठेतरी आउटलेट राहतो, मग त्या आउटलेट मार्फत त्या डोंगरामधून पाणी आपल्याला कुठेतरी बाहेर आलेलं दिसतं, म्हणजे तो आपला झरा झाला, आपण त्याला स्प्रिंग असं म्हणतो. And after that spring also joins the stream, म्हणजे सुरुवातीला कुठेतरी ओढ्याला मिळते किंवा नदीला मिळते, आणि नंतर ना पुढे जाऊन ती सी आणि ओशियन म्हणजे समुद्राला कुठेतरी जाऊन मिळते. म्हणजे थोडक्यात काय होतं की काही अमाऊंट ऑफ वॉटर जे जमिनीमध्ये मुरलेलं होतं, दॅट अमाऊंट ऑफ वॉटर यूज टू मूव्ह फर्दर इन अ डाऊनवर्ड डिरेक्शन, अँड इट जॉईन्स द ऍक्विफर्स, अँड आफ्टर दॅट इट कम्स आउट फ्रॉम द सम सुटेबल लोकेशन्स, that is through the springs, and again joins to the water bodies. Some amount of the water gets absorbed by the various trees and the grasses or the crops, we can say. म्हणजे काही प्रमाणामध्ये पाणी काय होणार आता जमिनीवरती पडलेलं ते जे झाडं असणार जे क्रॉप्स असणार शेतामधली किंवा फॉरेस्ट असणार त्या फॉरेस्ट मधली झाडं काय करतात तर ते पाणी स्वतः ऍब्सॉर्ब करून घेतात आणि ऍब्सॉर्ब करून घेतलेलं पाणी जे असणार आहे ते त्यांच्या रिक्वायरमेंट प्रमाणे युटिलाइज करणार आणि शिल्लक राहिलेलं ऍडिशनल जे काय असणार ते पुन्हा त्यांच्या पानांमार्फत बाहेर येणार दे आर गोइंग टू रिलीज दॅट वॉटर थ्रू द दे आर लूज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्मॉल ड्रॉपलेट्स म्हणजे सुरुवातीला काय झालं की सर्वच्या सर्व पाण्याची वाफ झाली त्याचं रूपांतर ढगांमध्ये झालं ढगांचं कंडेन्सेशन झालं आणि कंडेन्सेशन झाल्यानंतर ना पुन्हा पाऊस पडला आणि पावसाचं पाणी पुन्हा समुद्रामध्ये गेलं काही पाणी झाडाने ऍब्सॉर्ब केलं पुन्हा समुद्रामधल्या पाण्याचं इव्हॅपोरेशन झालं झाडाने एक्स्ट्रा ऍडिशनल जे पाणी ऍब्सॉर्ब केलेलं होतं ते त्यांच्या पानांमधून बाहेर पडलं त्याचं इव्हॅपो ट्रान्सपिरेशन झालं आणि पुन्हा ती पाण्याची वाफ होऊन पुन्हा ढग तयार झाले इट मीन्स दॅट व्हॉट एव्हर दिस इव्हॅपोरेशन कंडेन्सेशन प्रेसिपिटेशन इज देअर दिट कंटिन्यूज थ्रू आउट द इयर बिलीव मी दॅट व्हॉट एव्हर द सायकल ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द मान्सून इज टू स्टार्ट इट इज अ कंटिन्युअस प्रोसेस इट इज अन थ्रू आउट द इयर वी कॅन से बिकॉज व्हॉट एव्हर द इव्हॅपोरेशन इज टू ऑकर दॅट इव्हॅपोरेशन इज द मेन कॉज टू हॅव एन अ प्रेसिपिटेशन सो दिस इज अबाउट एन अ हायड्रोलॉजिक सायकल म्हणजे याच्यामध्ये काय काय होत आहे तर पाण्याची जी काही पाणी असणार आहे त्या पाण्याची टॉप सर्फेसचं इव्हॅपोरेशन होतं त्याचा फेज चेंज होतो फ्रॉम लिक्विड टू द एअर येस 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 दे आर देअर इन पाण्याचं पहिल्यांदा काय होणार बाष्पीभवन होणार बाष्पीभवन झाल्यानंतर ना जे काही पाणी असणार ते पाणी पुढे वरती जाणार ओके आय विल रिपीट इट सो दिस सायकल इन द कोलॅबोरेशन वी कॅन से दॅट फ्रॉम द इव्हॅपोरेशन फेज ऑफ द वॉटर फ्रॉम द वॉटर बॉडीज अँड इव्हॅपो ट्रान्सपिरेशन फ्रॉम द लीव्ज ऑफ द ट्रीज अँड क्रॉप्स whatever the evaporated mass is there that is whatever the water vapors are there those water vapors moves in a vertically upward direction due to the and they gets condensed therein and about and the specific conditions of the precipitation those are most essential that is having an cold air front we can say by coming in contact with that there occurs a condensation mhanje kay jalo ki after evaporation there is to form a some mass of the water vapors that mass we can say here as an clouds and those clouds if there is a no blowing wind in that case they remains there or if there is a prevailing wind or if there is a change in a pressure or there is a pressure difference in that case it moves towards the low pressure belt we can say it is from higher pressure belt to the lower pressure belt and if there the conditions are having the colder and colder in that case the total condensation of that water vapors is to occur or the clouds is to occur and that condensed mass is to fall on the ground surface or on the seas and oceans in the form of the precipitation and after that precipitation again it joins the oceans and the seas or the water bodies and against there occurs the evaporation from the top surfaces of the water bodies and from the leaves of the plants or the crops and again there is a formation of the clouds then condensation and again precipitation so this is about the cycle of the hydraulic cycle of the formation of precipitation okay tela apan marathi madhe चक्र असं म्हणतो म्हणजे कारण ही कंटिन्युअस प्रोसेस आहे पाण्याचं इव्हॅपोरेशन होणार नंतर ना ते इव्हॅपोरेटेड झालेली पाण्याची जी वाफ असणार आहे ती वरती जाणार तिथे जाऊन त्याचे ढग तयार होणार ढगांना नंतर ना थंड हवा लागली किंवा त्यांचं कंडेन्सेशन झालं कोल्ड मास तयार कॉन्टॅक्टमध्ये आलं की त्यांचं कंडेन्सेशन होऊन पुन्हा फेज चेंज होणार म्हणजे वॉटर बॉडी दॅट वॉटर वेपर्स आर चेंजिंग टू द वॉटर मॉलिक्युल्स आणि वॉटर मॉलिक्युल तयार झाले की पुन्हा ते त्यांची डेन्सिटी जास्त झाल्यामुळे पुन्हा ते जमिनीवरती किंवा समुद्रावरती पडणार नंतर ना इव्हॅपोरेट होणार आणि ही सायकल कंटिन्युअसली सुरू राहते सो दिस इज अबाउट अ हायड्रोलॉजिक सायकल ओके okay?